Hey guys, welcome to Couple. Please like and subscribe if you like this video. The Pentagon's top spokesperson was ostensibly seeking to make peace with the media when she headed down to the building's press bullpen about 3 weeks ago for an off-the-record discussion on how to improve relations. But the meeting quickly grew combative, according to three people who were in the room. When reporters raised issues like vanishing access to Defense Secretary Jim Mattis and other top officials, Dana White pushed back by criticizing the accuracy of press corps members' reporting. She made clear, according to the reporters present, that she was watching what they wrote and put on air with the implication that there would be repercussions for stories she and her staff did not like. White and the Pentagon's press operation have already restricted access to briefings, interviews, and travel with Mattis. But in recent weeks, several reporters said that they increasingly feel as though individual journalists are being retaliated against for stories they've written, losing yet more access. In one case this spring, officials pulled away a reporter's plum opportunity to embed with U.S. troops overseas following a story they found too critical. Another example involved the military news outlet Defense One, which was left out of a media roundtable with the Deputy Secretary of Defense earlier this month to help roll out President Donald Trump's proposed Space Force. The slight came after a Defense One reporter got an early scoop on plans to set up the new branch, breaking the story before the Pentagon was ready for it to go public. Kevin Barron, the executive editor of the site, confirmed that none of his reporters were invited to the briefing and said that White had conceded to him in an email that the snub was due to the initial story. Barron said White apologized for the incident in the email, saying that she was not aware that Defense One had been singled out and that the decision was made unbeknownst to her office's leadership. The briefing had been organized out of the Deputy Secretary of Defense's office. It seems Defense One was deliberately left out of a briefing in retaliation for our reporting, Barron said, adding that he had been assured that we would be included to all future, relevant briefings.